Random House Audio presents The Soul of Leadership, Unlocking Your Potential for Greatness by Deepak Chopra. This is Deepak Chopra. Introduction. Becoming a leader is the most crucial choice one can make. It is the decision to step out of darkness into the light. We have never needed enlightened leadership as much as we do now. Surely this refrain has been heard throughout the ages. But in the second decade of the 21st century, humankind poses a terrible threat to its own existence as we blindly tear great holes in the life-sustaining fabric of our environment. We can no longer turn to government, however well-meaning it may be, or to anyone beyond ourselves, to provide answers for the great problems of our time. And even in turning to ourselves, we must go beyond the constant clamor of ego, beyond the tools of logic and reason, to the still calm place within us, the realm of the soul. Here we can begin by asking the basic questions that give our lives meaning. Who am I? Why am I here? How can I tune in the soft urgings of the soul to fulfill my life's purpose and to make a difference? In answering these questions to the best of our ability, each of us must step into the role of leader, taking responsibility first for directing our own lives and then for interacting with other people at work, at home, and everywhere in between. As we continue to draw on the soul for direction, we will eventually find that other people are turning to us for guidance, drawn to us by our ability to treat them with dignity and to skillfully respond to their needs from a higher place. My aim in this audiobook is to give everyone the skills and insights to be a leader, not just any leader, but an inspired one. At the deepest level, a leader is the symbolic soul of the group. His role is to fulfill the needs of others, and when each need is met, to lead the group on to fulfill ever higher needs, lifting the group's potential at every step. The inspired leader's power base comes not from other people, but from her very being, and the path she walks is guided by her own soul. Its hallmarks are creativity, intelligence, organizing power, and love. Everyone who has a soul, which by my definition includes us all, has the potential to be an inspired leader. When you change on the inside so that you draw on the unlimited wisdom of the soul, you become a leader without needing to seek followers. As you put your vision for a better world into tangible form, they will find you. It is my fondest hope that after listening to this audiobook, countless listeners like you will discover their greatness and act upon it. Of these leaders, untold numbers may become public figures, and even more will perform a leadership role at work, at home, and in the community. Wherever you do it, there is no doubt in my mind that leading from the soul is what the time demands. As you'll hear, the leadership I'm talking about in this book is not leadership as we've traditionally defined it. According to that old definition, leadership belongs to the few. In a group, the person selected to lead may stand out as the most popular, confident, or ruthless. By these measures, not everyone can lead. When the strong and ruthless rise on the world stage, we find ourselves led by kings and generals. autocrats and dictators, power-hungry premiers and presidents. History traffics in myth-making, which is based on personal charisma and uses spin to evoke an aura of destiny. But these measures of leadership are flawed. None of the qualities mentioned here indicates that a leader will actually improve the lives of those who follow him. Chances are equally good that such leadership will bring misery, conflict, and oppression. The old definitions of leadership exalt power, and the use of power has always been directly linked to its abuse. Because leaders have turned out to be so completely unpredictable, and because so few leaders have emerged from the ranks of those who have seized power, we have been led to believe that perhaps there is some invisible hand at work selecting which leader will be great. But this is only more spin. The criteria for inspired leadership don't need to be shadowed in mystery. In fact, they are simple. Great leaders are those who can respond to their own needs and the needs of others from the higher levels of spirit with vision, creativity, and a sense of unity with the people they lead. You can be such a leader. The path is open to you. The only requirement is that you listen to your own inner guide. Once you step onto this path, you're on your way to becoming what I call a successful visionary. A successful visionary makes his or her vision manifest in the world. Invisible seeds planted in the silence of your deepest awareness become tangible, visible realities. As they unfold, you will manage their growth with passion and energy. Your purpose will be apparent to all. The results you achieve will benefit everyone, you, the group you lead, and the world at large. In a planet challenged on every side with ecological deterioration, everything you achieve must be sustainable, which means supported by awareness. This is an essential part of any vision of the future that draws on the soul. When I talk about the soul, I'm not referring to the soul as defined by any particular religion, although all the great spiritual traditions acknowledge its existence. I believe the soul is an expression of an underlying universal field of consciousness. Your particular awareness or soul is like a wave in this boundless sea, unique for a brief moment in time before it falls back into the larger entity from which it emerged. At the soul level, you are seamlessly connected with everything in the universe, to the silent domain from which all matter and energy spring. In this context, it is not surprising that the soul takes on qualities that are essential to creation: creativity, intelligence, organizing power, and love. If you find this notion difficult to accept, perhaps you'll agree with me that the old way of living on this planet is reaching its limits, and that the time has come to try something new. If you find that by turning to the soul for leadership in the ways I describe in this audiobook, you are able to increase the creativity, intelligence, organizing power, and love in your life and in your larger world, you can choose to credit your soul or not. It won't care, and those who share the world with you will be grateful, regardless of what terms you use to describe your new way of being. A map for the road ahead. Leadership is an evolving journey. The twists and turns lying before you are unpredictable, but you can be provided with a map. The material that follows divides the map into three parts. First, I have laid out the core of what it means to lead from the soul in a convenient acronym: L-E-A-D-E-R-S, with each letter outlining a key aspect of defining your vision and then bringing it to fruition. L stands for look and listen. Do this with your senses as an unbiased observer who has not judged anything in advance. Do it with your heart, obeying your truest feelings. Finally, do it with your soul, responding to the vision and deep purpose it provides. E stands for emotional bonding. Leading from the soul means going beyond the melodrama of living in crisis mode.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.